X-Files, Gibson Prays Revealed. Gibson Prays, is he a chess prodigy or a mind reader? A scared little boy or an alien hybrid who holds the key to Mulder's survival? In this feature-length video, Gibson Prays returns to the X-Files in a mind-bending story that revisits old haunts and rediscovers old friends. Coming up, the X-Files creative team takes fans and Fox Mulder for a wild ride into the heart of the alien conspiracy.
I was
here. Here we go, very quick.
And action!
Stay tuned for an inside look at the making of this X-Files feature-length video.
Got it. Brennan, thank you.
And meet Jeff Gulka, the boy behind the prodigy, in a fascinating profile of Gibson Prays.
How you doing?
They want to kill me, you know.
He seems to be some sort of a missing link here, a link between we mortal humans and the alien populace.
Mulder, I found something. I found something you're not going to believe.
Gibson is in some part extraterrestrial.
All of us are.
The X-Files, Gibson Prays Revealed. In the final episode of Season 5, two chess masters, a Russian, and a mysterious little boy faced off in a battle of the minds.
Checkmate.
It was a memorable introduction to a character that might just hold the key to solving Mulder's abduction.
He found safe haven in playing chess, where he could beat everybody. Then we met him again in the beginning and left him with a Dino alien locked in a nuclear reactor.
I told you it was here.
And now we find him 2 years later taking refuge at a school for the deaf in the Arizona desert.
Got it. All right, make your push faster. Okay.
Jeff Gulka, the actor who plays Gibson Prays, got the part when The X-Files was shooting in Vancouver. He was 10 years old.
Hello, young man.
Hello.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
You're a liar.
Well, the clothes that I wore in the first episodes was basically how I was at 10 years old, with like the glasses and stuff. I guess I like that look.
Now older and wiser, Jeff says he's quite different from the character he plays on The X-Files.
Let's go!
Well, he can read minds, and I can't.
He's got a dirty mind.
And, like, now he's scared of a lot of stuff, and I'm not that frightened because I don't believe in aliens that much.
You're a very special boy, Gibson.
I'm a very special lab rat.
Jeff just rolls with the punches. He does what we tell him to do. He scratches his head sometimes, but I say, hey, you're part alien. What? Don't ask me. And it works, you know?
How's my hair look?
Good.
What are you laughing about?
You think this incident might be some kind of UFO?
Got it, Brennan!
In making Requiem, the X-Files creative team covered a lot of ground.
Deja vu all over again.
The episode brings Mulder and Scully full circle, back to the site of the original pilot.
X marks the spot.
What are you looking for?
I was kidding.
Pictures up.
Big Bear Mountain near Los Angeles doubled for Belfour, Oregon, the site of the very first X-File.
Our location manager found a road that is almost an exact match to the road they used in Vancouver.
Oh, yes!
What I remember is a really cold, wet, graveyard raining scene.
What is going on here?
I think I know who did it.
I remember talking really squeakily. I don't know, I think my voice was a lot higher when I was 24.
Who?
Billy Miles.
The boy in the hospital. The vegetable.
Agent Mulder and Agent Scully.
Zachary Ansley played Billy Miles in the pilot and was brought back to reprise his role.
Now I'm actually speaking. I'm not in a coma all the time. I mean, complete surprise and a real wonderful surprise.
What's going on, Bill?
Just talking to some people you might remember, Dad, from the FBI.
Nice to come back and see David and Jillian and what they've done with this series and everything. It's great.
There's been a crash in Oregon.
Hey, man, look at this.
It's
spaceship was interesting. There's an environmental curtain that Jillian and another actor get caught in.
I was a little surprised by how big my headache was after I had to shake for 30 seconds.
For the actors, the X-Files phenomenon sometimes goes beyond the strange twists and turns of the plot.
How's little Karnak doing?
The weirdest thing that ever happened to me is I got a fan letter from a prison inmate. He wanted an autographed picture of me.
Gibson, get down. Get back.
But my mom didn't really feel comfortable with that. I don't know why.
A little scary, aren't they?
With Mulder on an alien spacecraft and Scully left to continue the search, it looks as though anything could happen.
They're coming here, aren't they?
As for the character of Gibson Praise, Jeff's hopes are pretty simple.
I'd like to see aliens come for Gibson again so then I can come back down here and film a couple more episodes.